Good afternoon. In the series of lectures of BSc third year, today let me start the new topic, bivariate normal distribution. So you know the normal distribution, isn't it? So in HY BSc only you are studying the normal distribution. What is the meaning of normal distribution? So let me write it over here. So suppose x is a continuous dynamic variable with period f x, then f x is, it is said to follow normal distribution if its period is 1 divided by root 2 pi sigma e raised to minus half x minus mu upon sigma bracket square for the range of x minus infinity to infinity, mu is infinity minus infinity to infinity, sigma greater than 0 is equal to 0 otherwise. So this is the period of normal distribution when x follows normal with parameter mu comma sigma. So for bivariate data set, similarly we can define the definition as x comma y is a bivariate continuous random variable. It is said to follow bivariate normal distribution if its period is, we have the period as f of x comma y. This is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi sigma 1 sigma 2 square root of 1 minus rho square e raised to power, ESP minus 1 divided by 2, 1 minus rho square, and again in the one of the bracket I have x minus mu 1 divide x minus mu 1 upon sigma 1 bracket square minus 2 rho x minus mu 1 y minus mu 2 upon sigma 1 sigma 2 plus I have, see over here minus 2 rho x minus mu 1 y minus mu 2 upon sigma 1 sigma 2 and one more term is there, that is y minus mu 2 upon sigma 2 bracket square, and for this bracket the common term is minus 1 divided by 2 and minus 1 divided, and all these brackets is e raised to power. It is e raised to power. Okay. And the range is because x, y is between minus infinity to infinity, mu 1, mu 2 is between minus infinity to infinity, sigma 1, sigma 2 greater than 0, and rho is between minus 1 to, it is in between minus 1 to 1, is equal to 0 otherwise. So this is bivariate normal distribution, and the we can denote this distribution as x comma y follows bivariate normal with mu 1, mu 2, sigma 1 square, then I have sigma 2 square and rho. Okay, so that is bivariate normal. So let's see it again. Let x comma y be a bivariate continuous random variable. It is said to follow bivariate normal distribution if its period is 1 divided by 2 pi sigma 1 sigma 2 square root of 1 minus rho square exp into bracket minus 1 divided by 2 1 minus rho square into bracket into another bracket x minus mu 1 upon sigma 1 bracket square minus 2 rho x minus mu 1 y minus mu 2 divided by sigma 1 sigma 2 plus y minus mu 2 upon sigma 1 bracket square 4 bracket complete. And the range becomes x, y, mu 1, mu 2 is in between minus infinity to infinity, sigma 1, sigma 2 greater than 0, rho is in between minus 1 to 1, is equal to 0. Otherwise, we denote this distribution as x, y follows bivariate normal with mu 1, mu 2, sigma 1, square, sigma 2, square, and rho. Okay? So that is the definition of bivariate normal distribution. Fine. Now, let me find marginal distribution or marginal probability density function of x, that is period of x alone. Period of x alone. So what is given to me? This is given to me. Okay. So that means x, let x comma y be a bivariate continuous random variable, then it is said to follow bivariate normal with this period. Now to find marginal, we need to have, so let me give you the board. y minus mu 2 divided by sigma 1 sigma 2 plus y minus mu 2 upon sigma 2 bracket square, and that is how it is. So that is the formula. Fine. Now let me write over here. So now we can put x minus mu 1 upon sigma 1 is equal to x dash, and y minus mu 2 upon sigma 2 is equal to y dash. Since over here integration with respect to y, we can take the derivative of this only. So derivative of this is dy is equal to sigma 2 dy dash. Okay. For simplification purpose, we have this. So now what we have is, so f of x is equal to the term outside the bracket as it is sigma 1 sigma 2 square root of 1 minus 2 square as it is. Now in the bracket, I have. So if you observe the range of y is minus infinity to infinity. So what is the range of now y dash? So if I put minus infinity, the range of y dash is minus infinity. If I put range of y as infinity, the range of y dash is also infinity. So the range of y dash is minus infinity to infinity. Same. Okay. Then exp, what we have? We have minus 1 divided by 2, 1 minus rho square, and so in the bracket now. Instead of x minus mu 1 sigma 1, I have x dash. So x dash is square minus. Again, what we have? X minus mu 1 is nothing but sigma 1 x dash. Sigma 1 x dash. So let me put the value. So 2 rho sigma 1 x dash plus we have y minus mu 2 means sigma 2 y dash. So sigma 2 y dash in sigma 2 y dash divided by sigma 1 sigma 2. Okay? So I can simply put value of x minus mu 1. So value of x minus mu 1 is sigma 1 x dash. Okay? And again y minus mu 2 is sigma 2 y dash in denominator I mean. Plus the whole bracket, this bracket. That is y minus mu 2 upon sigma 2 square. This comes as y dash. So y dash is square. So y dash square, and we can put the value of dy as sigma 2 dy dash. Okay? So that means we can write over here sigma 2 dy dash. Okay. Now we have what we have C. So that means if you observe this sigma 2 will cancel. Okay? Sigma 2 will cancel. Okay. This sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 1, sigma 2 get cancelled. Right? And so we have what we have now. So the term is 2 pi sigma 1 square root of 1 minus rho square minus infinity to infinity. I have minus 1 divided by 2, 1 minus rho square into bracket x dash square minus 2 rho. I have what we have? Sigma 1 sigma 2 cancel. So I have x dash y dash plus y dash square dy dash. Okay? So this is the type. So let me write one more step over here. Now over here we can adjust a term which is so that we get a square term. We adjust one term so that it gives the square term. So square term in the form of y dash. So y dash is square minus 2 rho x dash y dash. Then we need to add 4 rho square x dash square and minus 4 rho square, or not 4, it is only rho. Rho square x dash square and rho square minus rho square x dash square and plus rho square x dash square. Okay? So that is the term we need to add so that we get a square term. So let me write the state actually so that you get actually what I need to say to you. Okay, so that is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi sigma 2 square root of 1 minus rho square minus infinity infinity exp minus 1 divided by 2 1 minus rho square. Now, I can have y dash square minus 2 rho x dash y dash plus. Now to square the bracket, what I need to add? I need to add rho square x dash square. I need need to subtract. What do we need to subtract minus? I need to subtract minus rho square, x dash square, and plus x dash square at b. This is the bracket only, isn't it? So x dash square dy dash. Now, what do you have? So this is equal to now. So this is equal to now. So this is my square root. Okay? Square root of y dash minus rho x dash bracket square. Okay? And from this bracket we can take x dash square common. And hence what we get is 1 minus rho square. Okay? So let me write your step. And it becomes 1 divided by 2 pi sigma 2 square root of 1 minus rho square. Means the bracket minus infinity to infinity. EXP. Now, we can give this term, means 1 comma, minus rho square to both the terms. This is one term and this is my second term. Okay. So for first term, what we have? We have y dash minus rho x dash square. Denominator we have minus 2, 1 minus rho square. This is the term. Okay? Again, for second term also, we can have the same. So, if I take only this plus, then what we get in this one? Okay. So, if I take x dash square form, so what we get 1 minus rho square. So, see the term. X dash square common. So, what we have 1 minus rho square. Divided by, we have minus. Minus 2, 1 minus rho square. Then I have this bracket here, this bracket from here, that is dy dash. Very clear, sir? That is in the first bracket, what we have? We have y dash minus rho x dash square. And in the denominator, we have the curl. Minus 2, 1 minus rho square. Plus, we have from this bracket, we can take common as x dash square. So, it is that square we have 1 minus rho square divided by minus 2 1 minus rho square dy dash. Okay. So we have some simplification terms as follows. So we have f x is equal to now. So over here if you observe, since the integration with respect to y, this term doesn't contain y, it comes up from the integration sign. And over here if you observe, 1 minus rho square, 1 minus rho square get cancelled. We have e raised to power minus half x dash square. That is the term which is coming from the integration sign. And hence we have, you have 1 divided by 2 pi sigma 2. I have square root of 1 minus rho square. Then e raised to power minus half x dash square. This term. Exactly. Minus half. This is minus half. Minus half x. And since and in the bracket, you have in the integration. In the integration, you have EXP and I have the curve. In the EXP, you have V y dash minus rho x dash square divided by minus 2 1 minus rho square. Okay. V y dash. Getting the concept. Right? Since this curve is free from y dash, outside the integral line. So what the term is? 1 minus rho square, 1 minus rho square get cancelled. So we have e raised to power x dash square divided by minus 2. That means this minus half x dash square. That is the term which comes out from the integration side. Okay? Now, to solve this, let me have put, we can put y dash minus rho x dash is equal to z. So if we put this as z, what we get? So we get dy dash is equal to dz. And what about the range? The range of y dash is minus infinity to infinity. So if I put minus infinity, the range of z is minus infinity only. And if I put infinity, the range of z is infinity only. So I can write this. So f of x is equal to is power minus half is exactly square divided by 2 pi sigma 2 square root of 1 minus rho square minus infinity to infinity. CHP. What CHP comes? So this comes as C. We can put this as Z. So this is Z square upon we have minus 2 and minus rho square added to. And instead of divide that, we have the Z. That is the only difference. So over here we know that. What do you know? I know one rule which I directly used over here. It is E raised to minus infinity to infinity E raised to minus AZ square DZ. This can be written as square root of pi by A. This can be written as square root of pi by A. Okay. So if you observe the term, so let me have over here now. If you observe the term over here, the minus z square is here, minus z square. So the ratio of A is 1 divided by 2, 1 minus rho square. So A is 1 divided by 2, 1 minus rho square. Okay. So that means my fx is equal to the answer of integral becomes only this. The constant term which is outside the bracket, it is as it is. Okay. Constant for integration only. So, the answer of integration is now square root of pi by a, square root of pi by a. So, divided by this entity. So, divided by a. A means this entity. And this entity is 1 here. Hence, we can write this as pi into 2, 1 minus rho square. Okay? So, now we simplify the term. So, what we get? So we have square root of 2 pi and 2 pi. So we have square root of 2 pi in the denominator. So what we have now? E raised to minus half x dash square. Square root of 2 pi, sigma 2. And square root of 1 minus rho square, square root of 1 minus rho square, you get cancel. Okay? So now, and again we know that what we know? X dash is equal to x minus mu 1 upon sigma 1. Isn't it? This is the term which we need to put over here. It is 1 divided by the root of 2 pi sigma. No, actually, in the I have sigma 1, not sigma 2. So, sigma 1, we have e raised to power minus half x minus mu 1 upon sigma 1 bracket square. Because if you have, y minus mu 2 upon sigma 2 is equal to y dash, then dy is equal to sigma 2. Dy, isn't it? And this sigma gets cancelled with sigma 2. Means I have sigma 1. So sigma 1. Hence it is E to minus half x minus mu 1 upon sigma 1 that gets squared. So this is the PDF of x. Or marginal PDF of x. For the range of x, obviously it is minus infinity to infinity mu 1 is minus infinity to infinity sigma greater than 3 sigma 1. So if you observe the PDF, it is the PDF of normal distribution, that is univariate. So it is normal distribution. So that means over here you are show that you are showing this as if x1 follows by if x1 is bi-linear continuous random variable and it is a set to follow normal bi-linear normal distribution, then the distribution of x or distribution of y is normal. Okay? With same properties of normal distribution. Fine? In today's lecture, we have seen what is bilinear normal distribution, that is definition of bilinear normal, and then the marginal